Well, China warned of serious retaliation for U.S. support of Hong Kong's pro-democracy protesters, and it has banned the U.S. Navy from docking in Hong Kong. China has also sanctioned U.S. non-profit groups which have been monitoring the unrest in the financial hub.
In response to the U.S.'s unreasonable actions, the Chinese government has decided to suspend the review of U.S. military maritime vessels and planes visiting Hong Kong with the immediate effect.
To Washington now, CNN political analyst and Washington Post columnist Josh Rogan. So, Josh, thanks for being with us.
Great to be with you.
Okay, on the one hand, this ban, it sounds, you know, kind of big stuff here. You know, there have been suspensions before, but never has there been like an indefinite blanket ban like this one. But then on the other hand, when you actually get down and think about it, the real world impact is that the U.S. Navy has to strike Hong Kong off a list of ports of call for R&R. And that's kind of about it, right? So there's some kabuki theater going on, for want of a better term.
Yeah, I think that's right. I think the Chinese response to President Trump signing the Hong Kong Freedom and Human Rights Act was muted. And, you know, the actual steps they took will have very little impact on U.S.-China relations and very little impact on the United States. Whether or not ships port in Hong Kong is kind of a trivial matter, and NGOs that are sanctioned by the Chinese now were already prevented from operating in China. So it begs the question, why didn't they do what they said they were going to do, which is to tank the trade talks that they're in retaliation? There's only really one answer, is that they really want the trade talks to continue.
Yeah, they sort of quarantined the trade negotiations from, you know, the ongoing situation with Hong Kong. And the U.S. president was asked about that on Monday, whether or not this, you know, pro-democracy bill, which he signed into law, what impact it will have on those talks. Like I said, he dodged the question, and this was his answer. Here he is.
The Chinese are always negotiating. I'm very happy where we are, and frankly, I could be other places that I could do all by myself and be even happier.
I don't know what that last part was about, but he talked about China continuing to negotiate. And, you know, this is a fairly standard Trump answer, but about, you know, essentially China wants to steal more than the U.S. And that does seem to be the case. At least Trump has the upper hand because Beijing is hurting more in economic sense than the U.S. So I guess if you're Beijing, why wouldn't you just sort of run out the clock here a little? Wait and see what happens with the impeachment inquiry. Wait to see what Donald Trump's chances are of re-election. Just sort of wait it out for a bit.
I think that's exactly what they're doing. Of course, if President Trump is willing to sign a trade deal that they really like, they'll sign it. But they're also happy to just delay. And that, again, speaks to why they didn't really retaliate for the Hong Kong bill. They know that President Trump is not really supportive of Hong Kong freedom and democracy. They know that Congress was pushing this against Trump's instincts. And they know that in the end, both Trump and the Chinese government have a political domestic interest in keeping these trade talks alive, whether or not they get a deal right away or whether or not it takes a lot longer. But the bottom line is that, you know, this whole idea of linking human rights to trade, which is what the Chinese were threatening to do, it didn't pan out that way. It looks like they were bluffing.
Although, you know, from Beijing's point of view, though, at least in the words of the foreign ministry spokeswoman, you know, this pro-democracy bill signed by the U.S. president, it's seen as nothing short of a threat to China's independence and sovereignty. Listen to this.
China urges the U.S. to correct their mistakes, stop words and deeds to interfere in Hong Kong's affairs and other Chinese internal affairs. China will take further necessary moves in accordance with the development of the situation and will firmly protect the prosperity and stability of Hong Kong, as well as China's sovereignty, security, and development interests.
It's that last part of a statement there, talking about firmly protecting China's sovereignty, security, and development interests. You know, in other words, you know, a threat to China's sovereignty anywhere is a threat to China's sovereignty everywhere. And that is a much bigger deal if you take the sort of the bigger picture here, beyond the immediate need for a trade deal. You know, and that seems to be indicative of a relationship between the world's only superpower and the world's only emerging superpower, which continues to go from bad to worse at a rate of knots.
Well, that's right. You have a Chinese government that's getting increasingly aggressive, increasingly repressive internally, and increasingly sensitive to any criticism. And this is what they say anytime the United States, or any other country for that matter, criticizes the Chinese government on human rights against the Uyghurs, Hong Kong, their aggression against Taiwan, you name it, okay? And what we see is China sort of expanding its ability to resist international pressure, to do better on human rights. And the United States is leading the response. And whether or not they succumb to these sort of threats will be a huge indicator of whether of where the relationship will go from here. In other words, China is going to threaten to severe retaliation. But then we have two choices. We can either shut up and succumb to the threats, or we can actually stand up for our values and interests and then leave it to China to deal with the criticism whichever way they see fit.